finish line advances, the light infantry are going to the flank, I assume. Outflank the Americans. These reenactors, by the way, come primarily from New England and New York State, but there are some folks here from Pennsylvania. So quite often we travel great distances to do these demonstrations. Due to the nature of the tactics and the weapons, once again, it's very important for the officers to maintain tight control over their troops. As the distance closes between the two forces, we will begin to see each side taking casualties. Chance of succeeding in any action. At the beginning of the war, of course, the American troops were patriots who came from their homes and went directly into the army, very little training, while the British, of course, were the best professional army in the world. It took time, it took energy, it took Baron von Steuben, but eventually Washington was able to train the army to a level where they could stand face to face with the British. Americans on the top of the ridge are now doing a bayonet charge to drive the British back. And the British are giving ground. Seem to be very aggressive today, but aren't we always? British seem to be retiring back down the hill. And at the moment, it would seem that the American tactic is to push the British into a compressed pocket where they can be annihilated. Reenactors who are performing today for your edification and enjoyment are all volunteers. No one gets paid for this. And in fact, one is required to spend a fair amount of money on uniforms, weapons, and travel in order to do what they do. But this is their hobby. They love it. And of course, they're all amateur historians. See, the King's colors being retired down the hill, save the colors is a key factor here. Greatest shame that any British regiment or army could, they would have a large number of men handling it. If they were fortunate, they would have horses. Oh. British being pushed into a tighter and tighter pocket.